Good morning to one and all of you, and my very special thanks to Vidyushri Sharma. It should not be like it's a mutual admiration society, but those of you who have not heard her talk, she always is the first speaker. So she's very impressive. So I always take pride to be a part of her course. Going on to my talk, predominantly solo practice, that's how it starts off, but how it will grow, can they survive? A lot of change has come in the scene of ophthalmology in the last 20 years. What solo practice was when we started 30 years back, but I'm not old yet, 30 years back is definitely not the scene now. Solo practice is how I would liken to this picture, a man with all his resources and all his potentials carrying in a bag and a tightrope walk, because he knows that one step either way, he could be in grave trouble. But as long as he has that focus in his mind that the life's battle do not necessarily go to a stronger or faster man, but it is clearly the man who wins is the man who thinks he can. And I believe at every point of time you have that positive rush of absolute positivity in your mind. There is absolutely nothing which you cannot achieve in your life unless health hazards or some different kind of lux which are against you fall into place. However, let's be realistic, this is not a game changer, the thought that you're going to go into a solo practice. It's like playing a chess game, and each move of yours has to be very studied. You have to be very contemplative, you have to be very sure. You need to have an extremely good relationship with the people around you, social relationship. And sometimes it would also mean moving to different parts of the country if an opportunity comes, because you never know, each of it plays its own dividends. Again, in your start especially, you have to be very realistic in your dreams, and you have to keep on working the logistics of every move, any instrument buy or any expansion plan. You have to be very, very strategic, and it has to be sort of, am I doing the step? Is it going to take me further? Is it going to accumulate my strength? And if you're strong enough in your mind, you're sure that you foresee a better future for yourself, then starts your confidence building in your surrounds. Because unless you project that confidence about yourself, you project it around, believe me, it just gets people towards you like a moth. And this has to be a consistent feature in you. You have to be consistent in your thought process. And I would say that, you know, you cannot dream at that time, because you're awake all the time, because you're trying to live a dream, and that kind of drive, badness should be around you. And as you start growing, you try to see how you can start becoming the first in your region. And we had a practice initially in Tirupur, which is a smaller place, and then we came on to Coimbatore. At that time, you know, you wouldn't believe in having an indirect or a slit lamp or the first laser delivery systems. You know, from there we started off being the first. And then over the years, each equipment came in, and then came. We got to know that Arvind is going to start a branch in Coimbatore. They have a brand name all over the country. And at that time, we were the first in South India to get, rather first, second in India to get a refractive unit. And at that point, spending crores of money to get a refractive base was a challenge. And believe me, we were supposed to have an in-service training, and we had to sit and counsel each of our patients for half an hour to 1 hour, because there was no clue about what laser vision correction was. But by the time our in-service guy came, we had 100 patients for the next 3 days. I remember we even operated two or three in the night. So that kind of madness is what helped us to evolve over a period of time. It was definitely hard work all the way through. But again, success story is possible in a solo practice, in a group practice, and an institution practice, because there is only one mantra which we all need to know, is patient care. And it has to be an ultimate, ultimate best. And at any point of time you get an opportunity to meet a friend, or that friend puts you, gives you a clue onto somebody, please go and keep visiting successful practices. And sometimes get a chance, go in and sit amidst them in a corner. Because it, you've not only picked up the best points there, you keep picking up some of those lacunes which are there. And please keep making note. You cannot remember anything beyond a point of time. Keep making note and see how you could inculcate it to improve your practice. And do not keep telling, classifying your failures as destiny, because the destiny, to my mind, is a path which you have taken, and it is not a chance, but it is a choice which you have opted for. And then destiny has to become a thing which has to be achieved. In other words, I would call it a burning desire all the time to accomplish yourself. And that is where Are we successful? I'm not sure, but as I'm on the podium, I call it successful, and a successful story for me did not mean success in terms of money or earning, but a personal value. At any point of time, if a bad glaucoma patient comes to me, I would believe that I would go all out to take care of him, and I'd be very sure that it is this patient which bring me next two or four patients, because I never believed in advertisement in a crazy way, but building a value in our practice. And then as time goes on, you start evolving your dream team. You keep positioning yourself strategically amongst your colleagues, amongst your patient in your society, and always have a cutting edge technology, the best practice patterns at every area of your hospital should reflect that you have the best intentions going. Even if it's a very small setup, but it should have the right optometry unit, it should have a small, very clear cut, sincere, straightforward optical unit, and that's how it should go on. But then, as you start growing, always understand, try to understand what NABH means. You may be nowhere near getting NABH, but try to understand what are the values and the guidelines of something which is going to take you further someday to accreditation. And in that concept, start departmentalizing your work. Ensure that you have a very good core administrative team, initiating maybe just one. But he should be having all the right protocols, all the systems, every way of keeping you, giving you reports. You should have the financial wizards with you who should give you the right projections and the right risk taking. You may be crazy in taking risk, but he should sort of keep you in bed and keep guiding you. And as you evolve, you should have a good HR team, extremely good marketing team. The marketing team should actually score all the local doctors in and around the place, all the schools, all the colleges, anywhere, everywhere where it's decent to express that you want to have some kind of a camp or something. Anyways, every way you should go. And these guys of yours should become the team leaders for you when for your future. They should grow with you. They should stay with you. So you should keep pushing your dream into them so that after a point of time, it's not your dream. It's a dream which is shared by all. Going on further to some specifics, your front desk should be the most important area because it echoes the pathos of your organization. And every point of time, 2 months down the line, 6 months down the line, you have to keep reevaluating yourself. Understand, are you going in the right direction? Never get complacent. It's not the coffers or the money which you're earning, because all that has a limited future. Keep seeing whether there is a growth which is likely to happen to you. Keep analyzing your own results. Do not compare with the others. Maybe that comparison is sort of exuberant to move in a further direction. But you have to keep seeing that you do not stagnate or grow down. And that kind of criticism of yourself and complacence is what leads you on. Always promise the ultimate to patient, but ensure that you provide. And I believe it's a survival of fitness theory, and it is something like a lifestyle pattern which is honed in all of us, but we can't compare ourselves with some other colleague in the north, because I believe climatically each region is different, and we need to relate to what your local climate offers. So these are the n number of questions which will keep coming to you. Where are you going? Are you set for your future? How do you get there? So these questions you should keep asking yourself, and all your goals should be very specific goals, very measurable goals, because it has to be small goals at a time, and later it could expand. But of course, having said all this, how being very careful again, you should have what is called a blue sky thinking, wherein you think that you can do it. Tell yourself, this is a world, is a stage. I have this role at this point of time. I will never get this life again. So let me live to the best. Do not keep planning for the next generation. I'm not saying we gamble, but they would take care of themselves, but you keep moving on. And in this gray line, when you're all alone, when you do not have a fundraiser for you, you do not have a township counselor for you, you do not have goodwill forefathers, then how do you go? Then you need to get into the very highest precipice of technology. You should have the best of technology, the best of surgical skills, because the best of that would only take a solo man further forward. In other words, you should become all that you can be. It's like literally taking the raging bull by the horn. The innumerable number of times when I've had bad arguments with my husband because I would think that he's going at crazy limit. What are we doing? Are we having a family life? I'm amazed how my children are good children, because I remember working till 10, 11 and all that, and having a birthday celebrations after 11 when the hotels were closing down. But then that kind of raging stimulus is what probably led us on those days to what we could achieve in a small way now. So we have to be very strategic in our immediate society. You have to let the society know that you project effectiveness. You need to study the market, because you have to understand what is the economics of that place, how are they going to spend. You have to keep your fee structure, everything. You have to see how your local competition is. If your local competitor is only going to be charging 100, you can't, just because your colleague in Delhi or Bangalore is charging 500, you can't do that. So you need to keep scaling down your thing. It has to grow in numbers. So you know, you need to do everything, understand what is around, keep having the right projections relevant to what is your immediate society. You have to be looked down upon with trust, because I believe trust and a good common sense and a morality is what takes you forward. You have to dispel doubts, you have to keep getting analytic, you have to create awareness. And awareness, when I say, it starts from in-house, it starts from your touch screens, your display, your brochures, your counselors, even your front desk, your sisters leading the patient from the refraction unit to another doctor should be talking the same language. And how you do it, outside your working hours, but everybody should be in the same line of thinking. You need to organize public meetings, lines meeting, rotary meetings, any meeting, anywhere. You might have an audience as small as this, but you won't believe, I spoke in a place in Japan about some femtocataract and how do I establish my setup. The audience was good, but I never knew all of them look like Chinese and Korean. And one of those top doctors, I met him this today, 2 days back, in a president's tea, and he said that talk stimulated him so much. So I believe that whichever public meeting you have, wherever you have, even if it's a small audience, each respect each individual sitting there, because he is going to be a spokesman for you if you have some kind of future for yourself. And your best projections could be to your patient who sits across you, who has climbed up the building to come to you with trust. He needs to know what technology you have. Start having state of art. The optical unit, though small, should look optimal. Your small pharmacy should have everything which you need. It should be so methodical, and even your canteen should be clean and orderly if you go to that level. So anything small or anything moderate or big should be so state of art. And as I said, you keep even try to understand where you stand, be open to new innovations, have a frank exchange of talks with your own doctors and colleagues. They would have sound suggestions. They have set aside their thoughts of private practice to be with you, so they are royal gems. So believe them and hear them out. Keep visiting successful practices wherever you get an opportunity. Understand that your patients are coming from different age groups, so you need to cater to different kind of treatments, so you should have all of it in your place. Sometimes some of them may be doubtful investments, like initially when you started with cross-linking many years back, you were not sure who are those patients you are going to use it with. It doesn't mean that it was a dead property there. We were very selective those days and more aggressive now as we realize. So sometimes you need to have multiple technology. The corneal thickness is thin, you need to have a surface ablation. If a patient cannot have a laser procedure, you should have access to doing ICLs. So patient who comes to you might need a retina checkup. So it should be a composite unit which you have as you evolve, not on day one. You would lose chair time. I spent hours talking to my patients, and now all I need to do is just pat my patient and talk a few words. But that's how it takes us further. And be absolutely be prepared that those 12, 14 hours you're totally devoted. Keep on building your team as you grow on, and always try to be modest and transparent to them, because that only holds them with you. You keep needing to understand that there is a change which is going to come. What you thought 10 years back and what you're going to think now, what I might talk if ever I get a chance on the podium 10 years from now, is going to be different. But then that is progress, and that is your choice. Even our advertisement should not be crazy just because Vasan was advertising all over the place. You have to be very realistic. If this advertisement, how many phone calls do you get? Does it pay back? Then go for that. Otherwise, do not go for that. Because I believe at all point of time, yes, there has to be balanced advertisements. You cannot do without marketing yourself. But market which works is reasonable for your practice. If it's your patients who are bringing more patients, please concentrate on them. And I think that takes you further on. And there are so many online portals which have come in. Keep tapping them. Try to understand. When you're free, do not sit back and just watch your TV, maybe TV news. But try to find out at any time. Sit in any group, any business. business guy, anybody, it just keeps on expanding your knowledge as to how you could go further, how you could mold your team. There's so many entrepreneurs around the place, and always believe that you may have a team, but then you have the power of bold vision, and so you have to think differently to lead this team on. Never lose out on any opportunity, any conversation, there is something to gain. We need to understand that the whole dynamics of the country is changing. The world over, there is rapid changes, there's emergence of new models, there's a huge pressure on profit margins, there could even be a decline. But when there's a decline, you actually consolidate yourself, you strengthen yourself, find your weaknesses and go in further. So to achieve something which you have never done before, you just have to become somebody which you have never before. Like to have more, you have to just become more. Keep responding to the changing landscape. Keep adding to your technology. Always be on the run and never let go of your dream. Sometimes there could be exclusivity in boutiques. I was talking of a solo practice expanding, but it need not be. You need not be one of the mining crowd. And I believe that if your mind can believe something, it can achieve something. Sometimes there are niche players in every market. You could be one of those niche players. You could be having that kind of a boutique practice. And you could go on. You could charge differently. But then, you have to lead the patient all through and make them believe that you are so utterly different from the crowd. I could go on and on. And I'm sure what I said is something each of us know. It's just that grasping the opportunities when they come. I believe in this thing. If a man is to be called a street sweeper, he should sweep the streets like Michelangelo painted, or Beethoven composed music, or Shakespeare wrote poetry. He should sweep the streets so well, that the hosts of heaven and earth will pause and say, there lived a great street sweeper who did his job so well. And I hope and wish some of the young people here would do their job so well that they remember me when they have reached their pinnacle, that I did help them to think positively. Thank you.